Hello everyone. Today we will be discussing that how should we introduce the topic center of mass. We have stated clearly the learning objectives to the student. Student should be able to examine the items and determine when an object will be in stable and when not in stable equilibrium. They will be able to think how to create balancing situations for a given setup. So we will arrange a setup in the classroom and then we will say the students should examine the objects on display. Then the next question should be that where is center of mass of each object? How can you tell that where is the center of mass? You see this arrangement. This arrangement is an arrangement of two forks. It is balanced on a matchstick against the edge of a glass. This glass and matchstick, they are balancing the weight of entire arrangement of forks. Now let us burn this matchstick. Burn this matchstick. So we have now completely going to burn this matchstick. You can see that we have burnt this matchstick, and even now the arrangement is in a stable equilibrium balanced against that single point. Now you can see this arrangement. Here we have balanced a CD on this single point. You can see the arrangement is in stable equilibrium. A little disturbance does not produce any unbalancing situation. Similarly, this is also an arrangement which we have made at home only. This is a wine bottle holder type of situation. Here, this is an inclined plane. If we don't keep this bottle, the plane is not able to balance on its own. But with the bottle, the plane is able to balance on its own. Now question arises, when are the arrangements in stable equilibrium? After this, students will be energized, and now you are to introduce the physics. They will be able to understand your definitions because now they will be listening to the things carefully and relating to the definitions with what they have seen. Once you have energized the students, you will start the teaching and navigating them. The demonstrations will generate meaning to your definitions and create a long-term memory. Now, once you introduce the physics that when an object is in balanced position, the vertical line passing the baseline concept, then if you will start with the numericals on calculation of center of mass, the numericals on the toppling of the objects, you will not need much effort. Moreover, in center of mass, we can introduce the numericals in a very noble way. You can have a set of arrangements, measure the masses in front of students, join them, and then ask them to create to find the center of mass of the arrangement you have shown. Okay, so you should all create such type of situations, and always remember that energizing the students, navigating them with your teaching, then generating meaning to what you teach, these are first three steps. Thank you.